In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Google Sheets to help students work on math problems if they have handwriting difficulties. I've got some created. Here's a simple math one. Nice and neat. If I want to, say, add 56 plus 24. Of course, I've recalculated that in my head many times, so I know the answer. But the point is, if we want kids to show their work, and this is a simple answer, I know 6 plus 4 is 0 plus 1, so that should give us 80. This is how we can use drop-downs in a Google Doc to create simple math problems. Similarly, if I wish to, rather than create it in a linear fashion, create, one over the top over the bottom, I can do, if I want to do 73, go away now, there we go, 73 plus, and scroll down here, 39, I can even do a regrouping if I wish, 39, that validation thing is kind of a pain right now, but it'll be all right, 73 plus 39, okay, if I add that, I know that that is 12, so I know that a regrouping, I put down a 2, and up here I'll carry a 1. So now I have 1 plus 7, which is 8, and 3 more is 11. Gosh, another regrouping thing. I don't know what I was thinking of when I did this one, but just to give you an example of how you can change the look of the math problem in this simple math issue. Certainly you can do that for multiplication as well. Moving on to exponents. I doubled up a little bit and changed a few things a bit, and so I have a problem here of 2x squared plus 2y is equal to 90. I decided that x is going to be equal to 3, and that does come up because it doesn't like it, but ignore that. Google said they're working on that invalid comment code. So we just have to tell kids to ease up and don't worry. So if x is equal to 3, then we know that 2x is equal to 6 plus 2y. Of course, we go through, subtract 6 from both sides. Now we have 2y equal to 24. And we go through our division. We know now that y is equal to 12. And so that's how a student can use drop-downs to do that. Skipping things a little bit, obviously simple math. You saw division, a simple division program. But over here I have a long division option that if I want to, use 42, and I see I didn't do a very good job of expanding the size of my font here, and I found that 18 bold is pretty nice with it being centered vertically, horizontally. 42 divided into, gosh, we'll do, I'm going to be very simple here, I'm going to do 430. And so we know that simply put, 42 into 430 goes in there. 42 goes in there one time. And we can subtract 42 down here. And that gives us 1. We'll bring down our 1. We know that 42 can't go into a 10, and so that is a 0, leaving us with a remainder of 10. So that's how we can use this. Now you might wonder, how the heck did this happen? Well, clearly it was by a miracle. But we're going to go to another sheet and really take a look at it. I start with one cell. And the secret here is data validation. It allows us to create a drop-down menu in Google Sheets. Now, I'm going to work on one cell and then copy and paste it to several others. And I want to use a list of items. Now, for instance, if I'm going to do, say, all of the numbers, I want to put a space in there first and then a comma. So you need to separate all your numbers by commas. So we'll go, and we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, and then perhaps I want to have some of those division multiplication signs that actually look like it, obviously I can put in an equal sign. And if I do want to put in an equal sign, I need to precede it with an apostrophe, and I'll put in an equal, and then another comma. The same with a plus key. Apostrophe, plus, comma, and I guess I could do a minus key too, so let's see, yeah, alright. We'll put an apostrophe, a minus key, and then another comma. How do I generate one of those fantastic division signs? Well, I use something called, not PVC pipe supplies, that's not what we wanted. Let's close that down, and I don't want to save that. Bring back up my alt codes. Check this out. Look at this right here. If I want to do that's nice. If I want to do a division sign or a really nice multiplication sign, I use Alt 215 for this and Alt 0247. So I'm going to go back to math input, and I'm going to first do that multiplication sign because it looks a little bit different than the X. I need to have a numeric keyboard on my machine. So yes, I'm doing this on a computer. I'm not doing it on a Chromebook. I hold Alt down and I check my list that a division sign is Alt 0215. I let go and bang, there it is. What I should have done is preceded it with that apostrophe, but I'm not too worried about it. I can fix it. Secondly, I want to do that division sign, so I'll precede it with an apostrophe, and I see that that division sign is Alt 0247. And there it is. Save it. Now I do want these to be a little bit larger, so I'll move it up to 18 and I'll make them bold. And so if I want to generate a division sign, I just scroll down my list, find it, there it is. Now I didn't center it again, which is pretty typical for me. Always figure this out. Get them worked out so you do that fine. Then, if you're good with that, this comes up too. What I do is I just teach the kid to click off. And we're fine with that. I can also just hit delete so that, backspace to clear that material out. With this selected and organized the way I want to do, I simply copy and then select my range, which is going to be my entire spreadsheet here, and paste them in. So anywhere I have the same options to fill the cells. And we can then get creative and work on any type of algebraic geometric term. I haven't done any calculus yet because I can only spell it. So that's how you can use Google Sheets and support students with motor issues and handwriting to complete and show their work.